Welcome to my channel, Fat Danny Lines. My name is Mona Lee, and today we're talking about crafting, kind of. Okay, so yesterday my son came home. He was so happy. He had bought how many was it? Eight bottles of Head and Shoulders. It was some kind of discount. And I said to him, while he was finishing his story, my dearest son, why didn't you tell me you wanted to buy this Head and Shoulders? Because yesterday was a special evening for the Kruidvat card holders. Okay, not sponsored. The Kruidvat card holders, they have a special evening once in a while. And they can shop between 5 o'clock till, I think, 9 o'clock in the evening. And they get extra discount, like 20 or 30% off one item. So he had like 8 of the bottles of Head and Shoulders. Actually, it was 4 bottles for 10 euros something. So he had not 4, but 8 bottles. So 20 euros he has spent. He was so happy. Oh, I bought Head and Shoulders, blah, blah. And I thought to myself, why did you not tell me you wanted to buy this? There was a special night for cardholders like me, because I'm a frequent buyer of Kruidvat. It's not only for the crafting, but also for the Lego dots. And of course, sometimes the occasional household items like dishwasher soap or whatever. You know, you think you need to clean your house. So I thought to myself, well, why not go today to Kruidvat? So I had this one on my kitchen table because I put all my advertisements, things, papers, folders, whatever it looks like. But it's we have in a plastic bag all the folders from different kind of stores, and this is one of them. So I opened every page looking for, roaming for discount things, you know. And I thought to myself, is this something like Lego or crafting supplies? Yeah, look. This is the special evening when the day before, I mean yesterday. So this is the special, you have to cut it out or you have to have it on your mobile phone, the app, the Kruidvat app, so you can get scan this thing, because there is some QR code in there, so you can scan it, so you get here 30% extra off, because they're already discount stuff, but you get 30% off. So if he had told me, so like 4 bottles of Head and Shoulders for 10 euros, he could have had 30% off the 10 euros. That's you should have told me. So yeah, like I told you, I was looking for crafting supplies and Lego, nothing, still nothing. There is nothing that I want here. So I don't have babies anymore, so I don't use baby stuff, diapers, food, you know, milk, whatever. I don't use that. Let me see. Is this something? Oh, yeah. I saw a couple of something that I want. I saw there some candy. Oh, I forgot. You see? I knew it. If I didn't bring this, I thought to myself, don't bring this paper with you. They have in the store these. But sometimes they're out or they have, or and I forgot to take them off the stand. I wanted these licorice bottles, because once I finished the licorice, I could use it for washi tape. That was my intention. I wanted to buy 2 of them. I've got today to buy them. Dumb of me. Let me see. Is there something else that was here that I wanted? Here it is. There you have it. In the corner. Oh, I forgot. I don't have to charge anymore. I have enough. energy in myself. So here there are toys. Here these are the newest, the latest Lego sets. So this is the set like this one. So you can have the cactus in the shape of this same case. But this particular one is secret boxes. This is from last year or this year, the first wave. This is the second wave. This is the latest one, the rocket. Where you put it behind, there's a box. It's a pencil holder. This is more for jewelry and miscellaneous stuff. There are new... Wait, is that new? No. This is the second wave of the bracelets. So I know about that. So they have already discounted this, discounted this. They discounted this. 20 euros. They have now discounted for 18. I wanted to buy this, but I thought by myself, if there is a pineapple one, I will get a pineapple one. I couldn't find a pineapple one in this particular store. But there are like 10 stores, Kruidvat stores, I think, or more around Rotterdam. So if that particular store doesn't have the pineapple one, I have to chase two other stores more, because the other ones are too far. I don't have bicycle anymore, so I don't want to go that far. So I thought it was interesting, the pineapple one. That is also 13 euros, but I couldn't find it. There's this dot that is also 20 euros. And they are sold for 18 euros. I don't know. They didn't mention the price here for a rocket, but I saw the rocket price was for 18. This is an old case. They say it was 15, but it's not true, because at the official Lego website store, they are sold for 20. So I don't know why they say it's 15. So like I said, this is the latest one, the dots, loads of dots. They are sold for 20 euros now here in the Kruidvat for 18. This one is a very big case. You can see this is a small case. Those two are small cases. But this is a big case because they have here the cactus, the pineapple, and I think there's another one. What is the other one that is in here? Can't see it. But it doesn't matter. This is a big box where there's numerous things, numerous sets inside this case. So, I didn't see this one, but maybe in the other two Kruidvat stores in Rotterdam Center, I can find it, but I wanted that one, this one, the bigger one, because even though I didn't plan to buy the cactus, but if they have indeed the pineapple one, then I don't mind to have the cactus too. That's the thing. So I saw there is here, they call it school fever, school articles. That means there are, here they have this stationery set. There is one stationery set that I did buy. I didn't see that one. Oh no, there's a notebook with butterflies. I didn't see that one. Well, I mentioned in the past that there was a stationery set was in a wiener dog and a llama. I did see this one, but there was no price on it. So I didn't know the price because it doesn't mention here. But I was inside the store and I found this one. I don't know what the original price is, but I guess like the other ones, like the wiener dog and the llama, 7.50 euros. But this stationery set box was priced for 4.99 euros, so it was 2.50 euros off. So I know that. There are other things that I found it interesting. This show was last year for the first time for many years. I think last year was the actual first show, but I'm not sure. I'm doubting, because there was other shows. They were having also did mechanical dinosaurs, very very big, but they were not. I don't think they were called a World of Dinos. I think last year was the actual first show, but because of COVID, it was canceled. So this show, it was so, how do you say it? So sad to see that this is a very laborious and very expensive show to produce. And then suddenly COVID came and they had to shut it down. They couldn't open for one day. So it was sad to see. So this year they had to redo it and people can go and see World of Dinos. But there's a sad news. A couple of days ago, the government, our Dutch government was... I hate our Dutch government so bad. So a couple of days, the Dutch government decided like, hey, 2,000 people are now infected by COVID. Let's see how the numbers rise. So suddenly the next day was 3,000. And then it went up and up, 4,000. And then yesterday I saw the latest news that a lot of people were affected by COVID. 7,000. So from 2,000 it went up to 7,000. So now I think 2 hours ago, I didn't see it on TV. I don't watch TV anymore. Our Dutch government decided that first they said like there's a word, I forgot the word, but in Dutch word we call it horeca. That means hotel, restaurant, and cafe. So in the English and in American language, I think it's called food service. What does it call? Service something. So I mean the food industry. That's what I mean. So our Dutch government decided that our food industry, that means all the restaurants, all the cafes, all the hotels, are not allowed to open till certain hour. So that means my son, my youngest son, cannot work anymore because his shift starts at 5. So how many hours can he work then? So that means there are going to be layoffs again. Oh, I hate the government so much. You know why soon the lockdown was gone in the Netherlands? Of course people come together and, you know, careful, come together, engage and talk, you know, in the vicinity. But I think something happened and some people are infected with COVID that doesn't know that they have COVID. They infected a lot of people when they go out, like discos, concerts, whatever gathering this is. But I think it's not the youth and the young people fault this time again, because all the faults that happened here in the Netherlands are all Dutch government's fault, because they didn't came too soon with a vaccination program. And when they had the vaccination program, they didn't allow the house doctors, we call it house doctors, but you call it general practitioners, GPs, are not allowed to vaccinate the people. And how do you say, other hospital or people that are have nursing degrees are also not allowed to give the vaccination. And what was the third point? Oh, the military, that have military or the aircraft or the naval, are not allowed, when they have nursing on their staff, they are not allowed to do the vaccination also. Because of these three groups that are not allowed to do the vaccination, of course it's going to slow the vaccination program. Of course people are not vaccinated on time. So at this time, we are not going to give the fault to the young people and the teenagers that spread the COVID this time after the Dutch lockdown. It's the government's fault. They did this to us. I am so sorry. We are not to blame for this. I'm so angry at the Dutch government, and now they have the new demands to make the people do something that they do not want to do. I'm so angry at the Dutch government. I'm so sorry. I am so excited and so mad at the Dutch government. So you know what? I'm gonna fold this thing folder up. Because I want to talk about something else. Let's change the subject because I'm going to be really, really angry. So I went to the store and of course I'm not allowed to eat it. But today is a special day and I want to open it. I want to eat it. So it says here, love at first bite, Koekela. Koekela is a Dutch, well actually a Rotterdam cookie store. And this cookie store sells cookies, bars. Like lemon bars, fudge, brownies in the shape of a square, and granola bars, and cakes. Because, you know, last month I bought a cake for my son, my oldest son, for his birthday. So, let's open this one. I'm gonna save this beautiful bag. I'm not gonna throw it away. And here, there in front of me is a lemon bar. My older son loves Koekela bars. These kind of bars. Yeah, they have like caramel, brownie, fudge, whatever. Ever. There's so many of them. And I bought a small bag for him, like 10 euros today. But for myself, I bought lemon bars. So I'm going to do something what I normally don't do. So let's start. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, my youngest son. I love you so, so much. This morning, I heard him running up the stairs. And I was looking down the stairs because I heard him running. I said, happy birthday to you, my son. And I did this duck face. I wanted to kiss him on his cheek. But surprisingly, he kissed me on my lips, with his lips. Well, the reason why I say that, because he's a teenager. He doesn't like to be kissed, or he doesn't like to kiss me, because he thinks he's too cool for that. But today, I thought by myself, I would get a kiss from his cheek, that he would, you know, do his face like this, so I with my duck face, with my closed eyes, I kiss his cheek. But he surprisingly kissed me on my mouth. That is so surprising for me. And don't come for me. I'm vaccinated. So there you have it. Okay? We're vaccinated. We are vaccinated. So today, Friday 9th July, is my youngest son, his birthday, his 19th birthday. I'm so happy. He's an adult. Well, actually, last year he was an adult. But last year was a lockdown. And we couldn't celebrate his birthday. There was no birthday at all. It too sad. I had to do my older son, his birthday quietly. And my birthday quietly. And my younger son birthday quietly last year. So we didn't do anything. So today I thought by myself, let's celebrate it, okay? With pizza. So I'm not going to eat pizza because it's made of dough. Even I eat this lemon bar. It's also with flour, but this is a small lemon bar, and the pizza is this big, so I'm not, you know, it's too much. So, you know what? I'm going to grab my spoon. Let's see. Can I find my spoon? No, my spoon. I don't know where it is. Let's see. Where is my special spoon? I can't find my special spoon. So, do I need the dessert spoon? I have a special ice cream dessert spoon. Where's my... I cannot find it. Oh, no. I have a special spoon that looks like a spade. But I don't know where I put it. So, too bad. I'm not going to find it. So, I'm going to grab the drink that I bought from the Islamic supermarket. But actually, I could have walked to at the Chinese supermarket and get this also. But I didn't want to go to the Chinese supermarket because it's always busy at Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays. So I saw this at a Moroccan or Islamic supermarket, and it's sold for the same price. So what is this kind of drink? It's a mango flavored drink. So actually, it's water flavored with mango juice, and they have basil seeds in. I don't care if it's kiwi, dragon fruit. I love seeds. I do not mind at all. But this is the first time I have basil seeds. So I'm not sure what it does or tastes. So I have to do it quickly. Like, you see, my candle is already melting. How do you say? Burning up. So I want to say... Oh, wait. So I want to say, to your health, my dear boy. My sweet, sweet boy that's now turned an adult. So he has to do some adulting from now on. So happy birthday, your 19th birthday, my dear, dear son. Cheers to your life and your health. Oh, I didn't taste the basil seed. Wait. Mmm. Yeah, it's weird. I'm gonna spit out, but this is how the seeds look like. They have some kind of film around the pith. So the water with the mango juice is very, no, not very sweet, but nice sweet. And this basil seed is very nice. It's hard to bite on it because of the film that's surrounding it. It's kind of slippery. I'm gonna blow the candle. I hope my son has this year a nice year. But like I told you, he works in the restaurant, and now the government has decided that the restaurants and hotels and cafe has to close earlier. So that means there are going to be a lot of layoffs, and people are not going to work at all because of this decision. From all the bars that there is, I only love and like the lemon bar. So how much does this cost? The bar itself, it's like 2 euros. But they say around 2 euros because they weigh it. So if you say, for like, today I went there. I said, my oldest son loves your bars. I'd like to have 10 euros. So she said, oh, that's almost 8 of these bars. So, she said, let us see how far we can go. Sorry, I'm chewing and swallowing. Sorry for the silence. So I mentioned all the bars that he likes. So that means all the bars that are there. Because I don't know the specific one that he wants. The one like top 3. I don't know that. So I named all the bars on there. For every bar flavor, I chose one of each. This is a good drink. It's sweet, but not too sweet. It's the sweetness of the fruit, so good enough. Right amount of sweetness, right amount. Excellent. And the fun thing is, there are these basil seeds that makes the drink some kind of playful. And the thing is, you can, when you empty the drink, empty the bottle, I mean, sorry, when you drink it all and empty the bottle, you can maybe put it in a box with water, and then slowly, after some time, you can take off the label. But if you like the label good enough, you just only wash the inside and then dry it, you know, you actually turn it upside down and let it dry, so all the water will come out on the other end. And then you can put a dry piece of hay or a dry flower in it, so you can make it more cheerful, decorative. I haven't eaten this for like more than a year. I think 1.5 years. I haven't eaten lemon bar for like 1.5 years or 2 years. Wow. I cannot scoop it off. Oh. I'm almost done. And then we're gonna start what the extra things that I wanna talk about. So chit chat. Okay, let's chit chat. A couple of days ago, someone was shot in Amsterdam, lethally shot. And the one person that was shot, I don't watch TV, so I don't have the pictures of him lying on the floor, wounded. I don't have picture of him before he was shot. You know, his profile picture for. You know, when actors have their profile pictures, actors, he has also a profile picture, but I don't have that kind of picture, so I cannot show you. You can Google it, but like I said, a couple of days ago, someone was shot in Amsterdam, and he's not dead yet. Sorry, I'm not supposed to say was. He is named Peter R. De Vries. So in English, it will be Peter R. De Vries. And the minute I heard that he was shot, I saw it on digital news, because my cell phone is the greatest. Next to my iPhone is the greatest. Every little news that is in the Netherlands, it will pop up. So I saw the news, I told myself, no way. No way. He was shot 5 times. And I heard that one of the bullets landed in his head. In his head. So that is very lethal. So we don't know by now how his progress is. If he is well taken care of by the hospital. That they could find all the bullets and remove it out of his body. because I am so scared for his family and friends that they have, you know, heard this news and stand by him and pray for him. Because Peter R. de Vries is a very famous man in the Netherlands. He's a crime reporter, a crime journalist. So in the past in the Netherlands, where criminals have done something, mostly killing people, and the police cannot find clues or cannot find the link between some different kind of things, he can find it. He has managed like to track the actual killer and handed them to the police. So the police could arrest these criminals and take them to court and have justice on them. That means they get a long prison. So the judge will make the rulement of to judge them to go to prison. So when I heard when Peter R. de Vries was shot lethally and he's still fighting for his life day by day, I immediately knew who that was, because this case was taken like a couple of years, and I don't know if you know it, but Ridwan Taghi, I know he did it. I know he did it. So I'm sorry. I'm telling the truth. This little man, he's so cocky. I knew it. When they finally caught him in Dubai, this Ridwan Taghi, and he was taken by his neck skin and grabbed him. The police grabbed him and took him on the plane so he could fly to the Netherlands and be arrested. I knew the moment that this came on, I knew there would be someone hurt. And people are hurt. People are dead because of Ridwan Taghi. So I knew that Peter R. de Vries would be in some kind of predicament. And I knew it. I posted on Twitter. I knew that Ridwan Taghi is that kind of man that if he wants revenge, he'd do it or immediately. Maybe he'd do it himself, or he will let someone else do. But he can also wait, because he's now in prison. He can wait. His revenge is some kind of like this. Best serve cold. I knew that Peter R. de Vries was going to be in some kind of predicament. I didn't know it was like a couple of days that it would actually happen. So now everybody is praying and hoping that he will pull it through. And then walk up to Ridwan Taghi and say, "You motherfucker, sorry for my language, I'm still alive." I would hope that he would say these kind of words to this man. And I hope that if they can find actual clues and evidence that he really did this. I know he did this. I know. Because he is the only man, his only enemy for this moment. I knew it. And I saw some kind of rumors that all other people also think about that he did it, that Ridwan Taghi did it. I saw police also think he did it. They have evidence. So, and people in his near surroundings, his own family, says he did this. So there you go. There you have it. The thing is, I don't have evidence that he did it, but I already knew he did it. I knew it. Because some criminals, I've watched a lot of criminals programs, documentaries, so I know a little bit about human, how how awful they think and how they can do these awful acts on their beloved or even strangers. I know how people think. I myself won't do these such nasty things because I'm a good person. I know already, I know by heart that you, also because I have a Christian and Catholic background, and you're going to say, how is it possible you have a Christian and a Catholic background? Well, I was raised as a Christian, but my family are baptized in Catholic way. So, yeah. He's very cocky, Ridwan Tighwan. He's very cocky, Ridwan Taghi. So cocky that when he was not in prison, he could kill everyone that he don't like. And even in prison, he can still manage to give the consent to kill people. That's how dangerous it is. Last a little bit. I enjoy this drink. I don't know why I didn't drink this earlier, a couple of years ago, or a decade, or 2 decades. This is an excellent drink. I like it. So I have still my grapes. Oh, I love grapes. I love strawberries. I love watermelon. I love melons. I love oranges. I love bananas. That was a bit. I think I'm gonna put a bit in on the plate. Okay. I showed you it's not a newspaper, it's a folder of Kruidvat. So I'm gonna show you, what did I buy at Kruidvat? Well, I'm gonna tell you, what did I buy? I go to the Kruidvat. Oh, what's going on? Focus. Okay, there you have it. You know, I go to the Kruidvat to buy Legos. So, like I told you, this actually is the price of lots of dots is 20 euros to be exactly 19 euros and 95 cents or 98 cents. But at Kruidvat, I bought it for 13 euros and 99 cents. There you go. The next thing I bought, for my youngest son's birthday, I bought these beautiful balloons. It was not expensive. I think the actual price was 3 euros, but they scaled it down to 2.50 euros. I bought another one, but I opened only this one to decorate his room. I didn't show you his room. I didn't take a picture of his room because he's a very private person. So I only opened this box to blow on the balloons to decorate his room. This one I bought, but I didn't open this anymore because I was done blowing the balloons with my mouth. It was traumatizing. So I was chilling in his room because he was out with his friends and some friends, okay, not a lot. So I was chilling in his room and I was sitting on his bed. I was blowing these balloons. But these balloons has confetti. So I said to myself, ooh, be careful when you blow the balloons. Because if you're not careful and you suck the air in, maybe you will suck the confetti in your throat. So I said to myself, be careful when you blow it. So I was like halfway and I heard someone the door. I'm like, oh, shoot. I heard someone put the key in the door, outside door, and tried to open it. So I told myself, oh, no way. I'm not done blowing the balloons. These 10 balloons. I'm not done. So I was blowing in the balloon and I looked up at the door. I stopped, but I didn't hold the balloon too good. So while I was, like I said, blowing in, and I watched the door, because his room, you can see the hallway and the front door. While I was holding a balloon, and suddenly the air sucked back in my throat. And I was shook. I was shell-shocked. And I was stupid. I didn't do anything. I was shocked. And then suddenly, the confetti came inside my throat. And I thought I was dying. There was some the confetti on my tongue. My tongue was wet. But there was some other confetti that was on the upper inside of my mouth, where the first set of teeth, the upper teeth are, you know, where the teeth and molars are. I was running to the, I grabbed all the balloons and all the scissors and the tape, and this was like this, so like on the bed, I had to stack everything on top of each other so I could run easily to the bathroom. I laid everything on the floor because I was washing also some clothes. Well, I didn't wash it. The clothes washing machine did all of it. But I had to also check the time. And I was looking at the door. I was the person was still could not open the door. I thought to myself, what's going on? I gave my two sons the best keys so they could smoothly open the door. I got a key that I had to remake at the shoemaker that also makes keys, or it's better to say make copies of keys. So I had one copy that was not, it did go inside the slot of the key did go inside the slot, but it had a weird thing that if you turn it, it wouldn't go smoothly, so you have to wiggle the door. So I thought to myself, why is he having trouble with the front door? But I'm still blowing the balloons. So I had to run to the bathroom, throw everything on the floor, and turn on the tap and drink water. First, I grabbed all the confetti, the wet confetti on my tongue, and threw it on the waste bin underneath the sink. But the other ones on top, I couldn't grab because they were stuck. They were stuck on the... We call it in the Dutch gehemelte, verhemelte, huig. Okay, huig in Dutch. I don't know how to say it in English. But luckily, I drank some water and managed to swallow whatever was stuck onto my upper part of my inside of the mouth. Oh, I thought I was dying. So I peeped my head out of the bathroom, and because I've it's still the hallway, the big hallway, because there's a smaller hallway there, and then the front door. So I peeked my head out. I was thinking, why is he does he take a lot of time to come inside? And I see there's no movement of the door. So or someone went to the wrong door and stick his key in the wrong hole and try to open my door, or it's the next door neighbor that lives above my house, because we have four stores house. First two stores are mine, and the upper two stores are my upper neighbor. I thought myself, is the upper neighbor trying so hard to get inside the house? But I was thinking, no, he has the same smooth keyhole and keys so he can open his door easily. So I thought to myself, who is standing in front of my door then? Because it's not my son. I was in panic. I thought it was my son, but it was not my son. I almost died blowing balloons for him. So while I was in the bathroom, while I was drinking water, I heard a pop. I was like, no way. So apparently one of the five balloons that I did manage to blow, one of them popped. So I didn't close the door. So before he goes to his door, the floor is covered with confetti. And when he opens the door, there's more confetti from one balloon. So when he comes to his room, when he from outside activities, he already, I close his door, so he can't see the chaos in his room. He can still see the confetti on the floor because I did not clean that up. I thought to myself, oh, I am so tired. I vacuumed the hallway and the stairs to go to the... In the Netherlands, when the actual floor, we call it the actual floor, but in, I think in the English language and in American language, actually that floor is the first floor. Then the upper floor will be the second floor. But to us, the Dutch people, that's the actual floor, and the upper floor is our first floor. So I did this, the hallway, where same hall, the big hallway, you know, where the front door is. I did the stairs. I was vacuuming, I previously managed to did two loads of washing clothes. I had to do the third one, and the fourth and the fifth one. But I had to eat. I had to make some thing. Oh my God, there was, and I had to make two videos for my crafting channel and for my hobbies and toys channel. And oh, I'm tired. I don't know what's going on downstairs, but I heard some commotion. So when they came home, my son and a couple of his friends, I heard some things. I think they didn't plan that I didn't decorate fully. I did just a little bit of green, I don't know how you say it, garland, yeah. In the Netherlands we call it slinger, but in English language you call it garland. I did manage to do a green garland, and the 10 balloons, well, one popped, so it's 9. Did one I did not open. I was so tired blowing this box of balloons. So I was tired. So this is what I bought. I'm going to put it aside. There's more. What did I buy? Oh, yeah. I bought this thing. €3.99. It's a card box. There are a lot of cards with 20 cards and envelopes. But I had to open it because I want to decorate his front door with happy birthday, you know, for my kids. So I'm gonna open it. I already opened it. I'm sorry, but I still have to unbox it. So I'm not gonna grab the envelopes. The envelopes are just silly, you know, blank. So this chapter, it's called opportunity. No, not opportunity. What is the English word for? Yeah, it's opportunity. I don't like this word. Why did I choose opportunity? I don't like this word. Occasion. Yes, that's the word. So, gelegenheid in Dutch is occasion. Ah, I found the correct word. You see, I can speak English sometimes. So, this card is blank in the inside, but it's beautiful. Illustrated on the outside, it says here, "You light up my life." And this one is... soon be healthy, be better, soon be better. That's the word. Hang in there. Hi. And then this is a lot of animals in there. They have a parrot, a flamingo, I don't know what kind of monkey that is, and a zebra. And then you get the chapter, occasion. That's the first chapter. Then you get the second chapter. It says, gefeliciteerd. And that means in English, congratulations. So, It can be, you can congratulate someone for any occasion. So it says here, proud as a peacock, thinking of you, or no, thinking about you, just for you. Hooray, a girl. Hooray, a boy. So that means congratulations. And there's another one. What's the chapter? Oh. Wait. Did I do it? Yeah, I think I... there was... No, I forgot another one. It says, congratulations here on the bottom. And here it says, sweet, kind, and birthday. So it means that when you send this card, it means happy birthday to someone. I've got to add it with the congratulations. So this one is the, how do you say? Another chapter. It says here, thank you, bedankt. And wait, I need, there's another one here. Oh, wait. Okay, so yeah, I need to do it right. Because I took two cards out. Luckily, those were postcards and not actual cards. Like I said, it says here, congrats. So this one says a big hug to congratulate you. This one says today you have. Oh, that's a Dutch quote. How do I do this? Well, underneath it says congratulations, but here is a quote, it's a Dutch quote. It says, today you have a stripe in front of you. No, how do you say that? Today you have a stripe. I don't know how to say that, this quote in the English. It's a typical Dutch quote, so it means that you have an advantage today. That's what it means in Dutch. And then it says congratulations. And this one, it says thank you for everything. That's nice. And then it's this last chapter, it says, I don't know if you can see it, zomer. Not to confuse with zomer. This says zomaar. Zomaar is in Dutch... It can mean anything. I think the best translation is just because. Yeah, that's the best translation. Just because. This card says that was so nice of you. 1,000 times thanks. And then this one says thank you for your. Oh, how do you say that word? Commitment. Well, this word inzet, it means when you try to do something, you know, the first try. I don't know how to say. Thanks for your try. I think that's the best way to describe it. And then this one is a postcard. It says a special thank you for you. That's nice. It's a postcard. And then the last card, it says cheep cheep. Cheep cheep, that's the sound of a bird. Cheep cheep. Message. Cheep cheep, message. That's nice. So I'm gonna put it back into this box. The reason I grabbed this box because it has a jungle theme in, and a lot of these animals are related to South Africa. No, Africa and South America. So that's why. So when you turn around the box, you get here 10 postcards and 10 actual cards and 20 envelopes. So this here you get all the illustrations of the cards, postcards and cards. So what did I give my son? Let me see which one. It was with the animals. This one? This one I gave him? And there was another one. Oh, yeah. It said happy birthday. That was so funny. Here. This one I gave him. Happy birthday. And then this one, it says, what does it say? I can't see. I can't read it, sorry. Let's see if I can. No, I can't read. Too small and it's too white on a green back, light green background. I can't read it. I don't remember anymore what it says, but I thought it was so funny. I'm gonna put this back. Wait, I can maybe get a sticker off if I can manage to take it, get the sticker off. I do, and then put it on the. Oh, I forgot it. On the barcode, so I know how much I spent. I can throw this away, this plastic bag. Okay, what did I buy? I did buy more. Let's see. Was that the only thing that I bought? Oh, no, there's more. Yes. Okay, I found it. I found the cash receipt. That's on the bottom of the bag. So I bought this. I bought this Lego dot. It's called Mini Frame for 6 years and up. Set number 30556. And I bought it for €2.99. I think it was sold for the price. Like, not sure. Like, above €5. It can be like €6 something. I'm not sure the actual price, but I'm guessing. But I, if you know that I don't know if it was last month, June, or the month before, May. I already bought this at, I don't know which month it was. I do a lot of things at one day, so I don't remember a lot of anymore. But one of these months, May or June, I bought two of those. And I wanted the third one, so that's why I bought this. Okay, so what is the other one that I bought? Okay, I bought, I told you in that advertisement, that folder, of the Kruidvat folder, when I was talking, and I told also in a previous vlog, that I saw this stationery set, and it was like €7.50, and I thought by myself, I'm not going to buy that. It's too expensive. I think I'm spoiled with the Action prices and the Flying Tiger prices. So I think by myself, that's too expensive, €7.50. So because a lot of things were like this on discount, I finally bought the one that I didn't want to buy, and it was the Wiener Dog stationery set. Okay, I couldn't find the llama anymore. Maybe any other stores, card for stores, but I found the Wiener Dog stationery set. Look, and it's not for €7.50. I bought it for €4.99. That's a better price. So what do you get for this? I see there are a pack of stickers. I think it was like 30 stickers or more. Really? 30 stickers or more? 5 pencils. Do I have to sharpen it? Oh, I cannot see if I have to sharpen it. Oh, it already says here what I have. But I'm not going to say. I mean, I'm not going to read that. I know it's a notebook. An eraser. Oh, just one washi tape. One. Oh, I have sticky notes here. And a pen. And a pen. Oh, it reminds me of the 80s. When you click and there are several colors in one pen. So when you click it down, that particular color comes down. And you're done with that color. You click another color. That one goes down. And the previous one goes up. So let me read what it says here. What do you get in this stationery box? You get an A6 notebook, sticky notes, pencils, erasers. No. Oh. I saw only one eraser, but apparently it's two erasers. Oh, I'd rather they give me one eraser and two washi tapes. And a washi tape. One. And what's the other one? Oh, rainbow pen. Yeah, that's the one that I meant. So, that's the front that you can see. That's the text that you can find what's in there, but actually, if you have eyes, you already can see what's in there. But in the back side, oh, no, it doesn't mention. It is not the one like the Bugs stationery set from another company, because this is not from the same company, I guess. I cannot see where they're from. It's not even mentioned here in the corner. Oh. Okay, let's open it. Because it's... Then my channel is a stationary channel. And I'm sorry that there are some things like Lego. I couldn't get it. I couldn't be like talking. And then you will see on the cash receipt that I did buy Lego. But I didn't mention it. So I had to talk about the Legos. So I'm sorry. I'm going to grab an X-Acto knife. So please be careful with these things. You can cut yourself. And when you cut yourself, it's not going to be very nice. And then always retract it so you won't have accidents going to happen. I'm going to take the film out. I call it film, but I don't know how you call it. Foil? Yeah. In Dutch you call it folie. I think it's the same. Foil, folie. Put it in my waste bin. Oh. I told myself I can't feel it. I cannot feel it. Of course you cannot feel it. There's... Oh, gosh. There's... Oh, great. Do you see this? Oh, it's great. For my shaker card. Look how big this plastic sheet is. Okay, it's folded on some sides, but the majority, I can use it for shaker cards. Oh, great. I'm so happy. Oh, they don't call it stationery kit. They call it desk kit. Okay, I'm gonna put it in here. Oh, yeah. That's... I don't like these kind of things. I'm scared for these kind of tapes, these double-sided tapes. Okay, luckily, the glue is not all gone. I can still feel the sticky part. Oh no, that's why I don't like this type of glue, double-sided glue things. It says, oh, hello. Actually, he's sniffing his own butt. So funny. Oh, look, it's, look, can you see it? It's imprinted in the paper. The eyes and the nose and the letters. What is that word? Embossed. Yes, that's the word. They have embossed it. Oh, I'm sorry if I yelled it in your ears. It's lined. It's boring lined. They're fine. Put it aside. So then you get the pencils. Oh, pencils, crayons. That's English. That's Dutch. And then, oh, the exciting. I want to see. Do you really get 30 stickers? Wowee. If I really get 30 stickers, then wowee. That's a Dutch word, you know, when you're excited. Wowee. I don't know. No, in English they don't say it. Oh, it's paper stickers and foiled. Look. You see? It's stickered. So the paws, the stickers and the bones and the woof, the lettering and the foil are all stickers. But you have to carefully pull it off. You see? It's easily you can pull it off. So you can have this kind of... Oh! You get only two sheets. Oh, those are different. Look, this one is foiled with blue. And this one is not. This one is foiled red, but this one is not. This one is foiled with blue, and this one is foiled with red. This one has a foiled red heart, but this one not. So they... Oh, that's nice. So let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is it separate? No, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 16. Okay, that means that's 16 on the other one also. 32. Okay. Oh, that's why they said 30 plus. Because it's 32 stickers. Okay. Oh, you get 3 erasers. I don't want the 3 erasers. I rather want washi tape. They only give you 1 washi tape. Oh. Unravel it. Oh, wait. I was looking for my ledger. You know my famous ledger? Where I put washi strips there in. Where's my last one? Is that my last one? No, that's not my last one. Is it? No. Oh, I have to put some Sonja Stegeman stickers here. I think I forgot some washi tape to put in here. How could I forget to put washi tape in there? Let me see how far we can go. Like this. Oh no, no. That's not a good idea. You know what? I'm gonna cut here. I don't want to cut his body in two. So I'd rather cut him neatly. Like that. And then, oopsie, sorry. Was not my intention. And then put, oh, not too far, too far. Like this. And then this part, oh. Why did I do it wonky? Wait. It's too far to the right. I want you to see that he has a body. You know, like this. So like this. So I can cut with my pair of scissors this little bit off. Let's see if there's more. Oh, there's more. I can put more. Okay. Oh, I see. Okay, now I see. So I can cut here. I must be careful not to cut the other dog's nose. I'm gonna place it back in that space. Because this dog, actually, his part... Oh, wait, you can't see. This dog, actually, his part is like here. You see? Because the next dog was this one. In white t-shirt and red stripes. So I can actually put it like so. Let's see if I can lift it. Wrap it around the corner. Okay, I did this. Nice. So now I've put it in my ledger also. Oh, I can't put it back anymore. Okay, too bad. I can't put the ledger back. Doesn't matter. Okay, so I've put the erasers back and then the washi tape put back in that space. So I'm gonna grab the sticky notes. So it says a sticky note in English, and in French it says fuyet auto adhesif. And oh, it's just one? Yeah, it's just one. Because it's the same design. I can see it here. You know the stripes going on the bottom. So there's just one sticky note. But you get a lot of sticky notes, I think, 50? I think 40 or 50, I think 50 sticky notes. That is loads of. But the thing is, that cardboard is so thick. Wow, I have never seen cardboard this thick. Not in Crafting World. And the last one, pièce de résistance. Oh, it's hard to take out. Yeah, I don't have nails anymore. I always cut to almost to the rim. So they call it rainbow pen. So and when you want the light green, you push the light green down. And then the pen comes out. And if I don't like that, I put the red. You know, see? Maybe you can see it better. I push the red down. And then, of course, I have to lift up. Oh, that's what I had to do. I had to push further and harder so that the previous one will shoot up by itself. Let's do another one, the purple. You see? Oh, wait. Yeah, no. I thought I'd broke it. I didn't break it. It still works. Oh, this thing I had in the past, but it's not the same pen. But it has the same rainbow colors. I had this one like when I was a very young girl. I was so enamored with this thing. I always played around. But this, I think this system is a little bit different from the other one. A little bit different. I think this one is smoother. I don't know. Yeah, this one is more smoother than the original one that I had. But I don't have that original anymore. I threw that away. Once the colors are emptied. When you use this pen a lot, it tends to, you know, empty itself out. So, yeah. You cannot replace it. I think it's difficult to replace it. Oh, you can open it from the top. Okay, but how will it? No, you cannot get those out. You cannot get these out. How can you get these out? So you have to put, oh, it's out of frame. You have to push it down, but there is some kind of another direction. So you have to get it into that direction so you can lock it in. And then, well, while you lock it in, it shoot the other one that was previously here, it shoot it back upward. You see? Okay, shall I do another? So while I push the other one down, it pushed the previous one upwards. Okay, it's now, it has no pen, so I can easily put it in this shape. I like this a lot. I wanted to buy this, like I said, but I thought to myself, 7 euro 15, no way. But now it reduced its price to 5. And I was looking for the other one, the llama one. I could not find it. So maybe too good to, so I would not spend too much money. Oh wait, I forgot how to put it in. Okay, I did it. So these are my, you can't see. Oh, I forgot to take the cable off. Wait, can I get the cable off now while I'm holding with the other hand? Yes, I can. So I love this Oppo cell phone. He has this beautiful big charger. It's a fast charger. I can charge my cell phone within 30 minutes, 100%. So I like it. But the thread, it's kind of stiff. It's not flexible. So when I'm filming, I must not touch the cable. Because then suddenly you see my cell phone shoot in one way. Very quickly. And in a way that I don't like. Because I'm scared if the cell phone falls onto the floor. But luckily I forgot. Oh, I forgot. I have a casing on my cell phone. So, and a screen protector. So I forgot. I'm well protected, my cell phone. So, it is a lot today. But because my cell phone has a lot of gig, 256 gig, instead of the iPhone that I had 65 gig. Or was it MB? Wait. No, it was 256 MB. And I had on my iPhone 65 MB. Why did it tell us that it was gig? It's not gig. So now I can film longer. Have you noticed I can film like for an hour or under an hour? Normally I have to do it like cut it. Well, I didn't cut it. My cell phone stopped filming. So I was forced to do part one, part two, part three. But now I don't have to. See? I hope you enjoyed my little... No, it's not a little. I hope you enjoyed my medium haul. It's actually craft. A little bit party. Birthday things, items. And my favorite, Lego dots. Or Lego sets. So, any sets is my favorite. Thank you for watching. I'm going to put you back in the stand. Because I cannot hold you and talk to you. Because my hand is a bit tired. My feet is itchy. I think my mosquito ate my blood. Drink my blood. Because I had some sugary things. I had the apricots and grapes. And that basil drink. Oh. I think this mosquito lost me. Oh, it's so itchy, my feet. I think he stung me like three times, three different places. Well, I have to say goodbye. Sorry, I rambled too long, too much. Thank you for watching. For the love of crafting, I hope you enjoyed it. I'm sorry, it was too long, too long. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching. Please be careful. Please be safe. Please be kind. Please be positive. Thank you for watching, and I love you always. Bye, everyone.